Well, she was crowned Queen of the Jungle on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. And now comedian Fiona O'Loughlin is facing a brand new adventure, becoming a grandmother. And she is with us right here in the studio. Welcome.
Clap yourself.
You know, the moment you landed in Africa and landed at the campsite, I went, you're going to win this.
Really?
Mm. Yeah, there was a real rawness about you. You were just in it and you were a joy to watch. Would you do it over again, all over again?
To get this result, yes, I would. Life has... It's like everybody was going to win it. Definitely I would do it. It was all worth it, you know. I think really I won because I'm a little bit dim and I could not keep reminding myself there were cameras there.
you won because you were just so real and you just didn't give a proverbial.
And vulnerable.
And you were just there and you let it all hang out. There's nothing fake about you. And there were all these tough guys who were going in there with all the braggadocio in the world and then turned to pieces instantly. And you were just... That's not even a question. I'm just going on.
One of the people that you did clash with in the jungle was David Oldfield, who made some comments about what he thought of Aboriginal people. And your son works in that area. He knows a little something about it. Let's take a look.
It's primarily their children dying prematurely. It's primarily their heartache, not yours.
Yeah, well, part of those issues
are
medically related,
you
which you're not aware of.
You make my skin crawl.
There you go.
My son would wipe the floor with you. I don't have the knowledge that he has, but by hell, I dare you or challenge you to meet my son on the other side of this.
Why would I bother?
Because he knows what he's talking about and you don't.
Wow.
When you have an argument and you want to edit it, you want to go back. That's just so inarticulate.
That's so sweet, though. He said, look, I don't know what I'm talking about. My son does, and he's going
to... And so stormed off into the jungle. Has your son been able... Has that meeting taken place, or is it likely to?
I had no business saying that because my son's a very private person. He does work, in the field, but he'd get a lawyer onto me if he hadn't mentioned his name.
Of course, you've lived in Alice for years where you see these problems firsthand as well.
And so you've fostered kids over the years as well, haven't you?
Yeah, I think it's kind of close to my heart because, look, if I just be as honest as I can, I've got the same disease as a lot of, the troubles that Aboriginal people have. I'm not saying all Aboriginal people are alcoholics, but I've seen it up close. I know what it is. He's a windbag. He doesn't know what... He might think he knows what he's talking about, but he certainly doesn't know who he's talking about.
Mm. Yeah, it's true. And you see, and it's just so... far more complicated than that argument. Mm. Now, you had a mock wedding in the jungle with Peter Rosethorne, who we love as well.
He was on the show earlier this
week. I was watching.
Tell us about Ron and Brenda and how are they going?
Well, it was so organic, you know, it just... Comedians have kind of this intimacy emotionally. Yeah. Just it's a shorthand, you know. I didn't even know Peter Rosethorne that well. You know, I'd only ever seen him at gigs. But once you come across someone who's on this, got the same sense of humour, and we just started improvising our way through it. When life gets unbearable, not that it was unbearable, never. So we just kind of, I don't know how it started. I think it was a way of releasing some tension. Basically, I could tell someone to shut up. So I had to invent a fake husband. Oh, shut up, Ron.
Now, the good news. Aside from all the other things of your life changing and to turn about, you're about to be a grandmummy.
Yes, I've got a baby granddaughter coming in September.
I just said the sex on national television.
Was that supposed to be a secret?
She's punking you. She's throwing that out there just to kind of, muddy the waters.
Well, look, they're going to tell me these things.
They're going to expect it.
So that's two of your children who are going to sue you now as well.
I need to lawyer up before I leave these studios.
Look, don't worry. As my best mate said, when he found out the sex of his child and before his wife had given birth. And I said, don't you want it to be a surprise? Mate, trust me, when you've seen what happens, you don't need any more surprises.
Are you excited, though?
I'm so excited.
What sort of nana do you think you'll be?
Well, I was a pretty liberal mother, so I'm hoping to be just a crazy nutter, yeah. You know.
Yeah, and get, have much fun with
I
them.
I want to have sleepovers. I'll be very naughty.
Oh, yeah. You totally
anything
will be.
Its little heart desires.
It's so going to be the one that spoils yes. the kids.
What are you going to be called?
What are you going to be called?
It was really interesting. When I was in rehab, there was this moment, and it is the moment that they... you've got to get to, and it's almost like your soul comes to the surface. And I had this kind of breakdown, they call it a breakthrough. Sounds came out of me that I had never heard before, you know, and it's the grief of everything you've done to yourself, you know. And later that night, I was in bed and I kind of felt very comforted. I had this overwhelming sense, I was like, a little girl saying, but Noni, I need you.
No.
Oh, my God.
I know. And then my daughter told me, because little kids call me Nona, like my little sister used to call me Nona, and my daughter said to me not long after she told me she was pregnant, she said, we're thinking we'll call you Noni, because Nona sounds, because you're not Greek. And I was like, Noni. So there you go. I'm a psychic as well. I'll take on that.
Oh, take it all on.
You really have to... as far as I know, reach that bottom to come up.
Oh, yeah,
you?
Yeah. And
it was so hard for you. I mean, you've gone through so much. I just am so happy for you.
Thank you, Denise. Thank you so much.
You've got another life. You
yes,
know, you've,
and,
you've, and this is the start of it.
It
and
does
it's
feel
just
like
brilliant.
The universe gave me my life
yeah.
back. And I would, you know, I'll continue to talk about it because... there are people like me everywhere, you know?
I was going to say, there are people like you, like, everywhere in showbiz as well. You know, I know we all drink too much, I'm sure.
But that's a different thing, drinking too much to being people like me. And there's people at home who know people like me. The aunt, the uncle, the grandmother, the vacant eyes, the lost one. And I was one of them.
I know. I've seen plenty of people like that. I've been that person as well. How hard was it to... go into the jungle? Was that the turning point, or did you feel like you needed to do that to have a break from everything else so you would be? Like, was that part of...
No, the turning point had happened before going into the jungle, so by the time I got the offer of the jungle, I did need the work. And I was just so excited to be well, yeah. you know?
Right.
And so I just thought, let's roll the dice here and have a...
You really had nothing to lose.
I had nothing
did you?
To lose.
Everything to gain.
If someone had told me I'd win the bloody thing, I could not. I saw. I still wake up and pinch myself.
No, we could see it.
Yeah.
It was just
from day
it was
one.
Wonderful
it was
to
just
see
it was
there,
so
really.
Obvious. There was a vulnerability to you. Before we let you go, because you've been so open and honest, how many days sober has it been now?
Oh, I've been. It's been 3 years, but a bust last year in August, which broke my heart. So what are we now? Oh, yeah, coming up. So that was not that I want to minimise it, it lasted 2 days last August.
Mm. What was the breaking point that made you... was it something or it just happened?
Oh, I've got an alcoholic mind. Every now and then my alcoholic mind will tell me that a drink's a good idea and it never is. Mm. I don't have any guarantees if I drink, you know? That's what separates us.
Yeah.
From the heavy drinkers.
From the heavy drinkers. You know, we have an inverse allergy to it. This substance for...
it's a poison.
Some of us, it's a poison. Mm. So I'm very ashamed of my behaviours, you know, that my behaviours when I've been intoxicated, but I have to say that we need to get rid of the shame around the disease of alcoholism. Mm. And, I'm past caring the whys or the wherefores. Some of us, and it's a society that all enjoys booze, some of us cannot have it. And the sooner we can just put our hands up and go, oh, I'm one too, the more can come over to this side, you know?
Yeah. You were so brave, and by speaking out, you were helping so many
Well, it's
people.
The disease I've been given. It's not very sexy, but I'll have to work with it.
You know what? You're funny too. And people could go and see you crack a few gags at the Sydney Comedy Festival. The show's called Gap Year. It's this Sunday night. Head to sydneycomedyfest.com.au to book some tickets. Fiona O'Loughlin, we love you.
I love you.